Hello, everybody. Ryan McKnight here, founder of Mormon Leaks. Some events in the last day or two have led me to make this video. I think it's important. It's a video I've been wanting to make for some time now, and I think it's time to make this video. This is going to be a topic that covers a time period before the creation of mormonleaks.io and really before the creation of Mormon Leaks period. Those that have been following our work know that I received a large amount of attention October 2016 when I released 15 videos that had been leaked to me on a YouTube channel that I created. And what I'm going to talk to you about is something that started before I received those videos. For those that follow me on Reddit and or follow the subreddit rxmormon, you're going to know a little bit about what I'm talking about, and you're probably my primary audience for this. So I'm going to be talking a little bit about my interaction from start to finish with a user that goes by the name of Mormon Documents. So I want to keep this as brief as possible, but it's probably going to be a little bit of a long video just because it is a pretty thorough topic and I want to give it the proper treatment. So bear with me. I realize this is probably a subject that not everybody's going to be interested in. That's fine. But this video will be here for those that are interested in this and want to know what really happened. Because I get a lot of messages from people wanting to know what's the deal with this guy. And, you know, is this guy for real? What do you think of this guy? And up to this point, I've really gone out of my way to be as diplomatic as possible I do think he is a real person, and I do think that he has told some truths. And for that, I have wanted to try to respect his privacy as much as possible. And I'm still gonna do that. I'm not gonna try to out his identity yet. I mean, if he continues down this crazy path, we'll see. I don't actually know his identity, but I do probably know enough about him that people who do know who he is, if I were to say some things, they'd be able to put two and two together and figure out who it is. But, okay, so this is how it all started. A couple of weeks before the general conference in October of 2016, so this would have been sometime in September of 2016. I don't know the exact date because when you go back and you look at Reddit, at least for me, I'm not really like super computer savvy. I don't really know how to figure out like what the exact date of certain posts were. But there was a post. I woke up one day there was like 50. I don't know exactly how many. I could be exaggerating. But there was a lot of posts, individual leaks, if you will, by somebody going by the name of Mormon Documents. And each post was a document that he was leaking, and the title would have somewhat of a description, and then the post was linking directly to the document on whatever host site he was using. It may have been Doctroid. I don't quite remember. And, you know, the documents, this guy came out of nowhere. I mean, I think he had made a couple of posts here and there before, but essentially this user came out of nowhere, so there was definitely some skepticism at first, but the posts appeared to be legitimate. You know, the documents, they had a look of legitimacy, you know, but nothing, you know, could really be confirmed yet. So he's making all these posts, and then of course they're getting lots of attention, lots of upvotes. They're all becoming, especially some of the more interesting ones are becoming the, you know, quickly becoming the top posts on the sub for that day. So at some point, he makes another post that doesn't have a leak attached to it. Now I can't pull these posts up anymore because I didn't archive them, and he's gone and deleted all these posts since then. But he basically in this post asks for money. He kind of gives his story about how I don't remember exactly how much he shared there as opposed to shared with me privately, but it was something along the lines of about how he had lost his job with the church and he was left with nothing, and he had these documents and wanted to give them to the world, and that he needed money, et cetera, et cetera. And he put a Bitcoin address, a wallet address, in the post and asked people for donations. Now, for those that know the subreddit, the ex-Mormon subreddit, they know that fundraising is strictly prohibited. So the moderators, I can't remember if they took the post down or if they made him edit that part out. I don't recall. But either way, the whole part about asking for money was removed in one way or the other. But it had been seen already by a lot of people before that happened. I wanted to help this guy. I mean, I didn't have a ton of experience leaking things at this point, but I had experience with the fallout of leaking things for sure, which he was starting to experience because when he asked for money, people started really getting on him. And, I had been involved with the November policy and a couple other really minor things after that. And I was chatting with the moderators. I don't remember who started the conversation, but it was kind of agreed that I would reach out to him privately and, see what could happen. So I've got here pulled up all the messages and everything. So I'm going to read most of them to you. Cause I want you all to get a clear picture of what's going on here. Let everybody, I mean, I am going to give my opinions. I'm not going to be completely neutral in this thing, but I'm going to try to lay it all out for you guys as much as I can. And then you guys can decide, what you think about this guy, Mormon Documents. So I sent a message to him. I titled it Financial Help. And again, this would have been sometime in September of 2016. It just says on here 6 months ago. So I don't know when it happened. So I said, I've been in contact with the mods and we want to help you. Message me so we can get you help. I have a plan. I don't really know if I had a plan, but I had some thoughts in my head of what I was going to do. So he responds back. I appreciate your thoughtfulness, but under no circumstances can my identity be revealed. You must understand how nerve-wracking this is, especially with all the hate speech being spewed by certain individuals on the subreddit, and God knows what's going on at the COB right now. COB, for those that don't know, is the church office building. I respond, I understand. If you change your mind, let me know. My name is Ryan McKnight. I usually communicate over... I'm going to edit some of this stuff out. So you guys are just going to have to trust me that this is real. But I'm going to edit some of this stuff out for his anonymity and, for some other privacy reasons. I usually communicate over blank. I mention an app. Also, I also want to know, I'm going to try to keep this a family-friendly video. There's a lot of cursing involved at some points, and I'll probably just try to convey the cursing to you guys in a more clean manner. My number is blah, blah, blah. I'm giving him an opportunity to call me or download this app. I have a lot of people that trust me. If after talking to you, I feel comfortable, I will set up a GoFundMe and get you the help you need. My reputation in the Exmo community will make this a success. Let me know. So, I'm just trying to give him a little bit of hope by saying that. I hope that doesn't come off as too pompous on my part. But, remember, these are private chats that I'm having, and I'm now exposing these private chats to you guys. He writes back, I sincerely appreciate that. How do I contact you on blank? He mentions this app. I said, download the app, search me with my phone number, send me a message. And then I said, also, if you have hundreds of documents, because he had hinted that he had hundreds more. I said, let's clean them up. Let's clean up the way you're releasing them. Let me know if you have trouble setting it up. I'm referring to the app. It should be easy. Ryan, I can't figure out how to use the app. It's asking me for my phone number, which I don't have because my cell phone has been shut off as a result of the fact that I've been left destitute. I'm sorry. And I respond, okay, can we chat via Facebook? If not, tell me how we can get in touch. And he asks, can we chat here? And I said, for now. Now, just so you guys know, I try to move chats like this off of Reddit, mainly because it's very cumbersome to chat on Reddit. And it's also very hard to go back and read the history of the chat. So I don't like to have long, extended chats on Reddit if I can avoid it. So I said, for now we can chat here. I have a couple questions. Some of the posts have been called into question as being fake. I have no opinion on that yet. How do you respond? How long have you been unemployed? What are your current job prospects? What has been holding you back to get employment? Did you quit COB or did you get fired? These are questions I'm asking him. So he responds as far as the documents being fake. He says, they are from the church servers. None of them are fake. I created none of these documents. I guess people are so used to reading fabricated materials, but I have no interest in wasting my time. Okay, fair enough for now. Listen, here's what I want to do. I want to set up a GoFundMe to help tie you over while you seek employment. I will vouch for you in the fund. I am confident there will be a successful campaign in the thousands. I will use some underground handcart company funds to help promote the campaign. If I am going to do this, I need to be a little more comfortable with you. I would like to see a Facebook page or a LinkedIn page, chat with you there to confirm it is you, maybe talk on the phone a little, something like this. I realize you will need to stay anonymous, and I get that more than you realize. I will protect your identity. Unless you give me permission, it will never be revealed. Even under legal threat, which won't happen. Let me know what you think. So then he responds by answering some of my other questions that I asked. So he says, for about a month, you know, as far as how long he's been unemployed, he says he's starting a new job on October 15th. So that's like 3 or 4 weeks away from this time we're talking. I had to move away to find employment and explain the circumstances surrounding why contacting my former employers was not wise. Which is an interesting point, by the way, because I think there's some indication later on in our chats that he never did actually move away, at least not a long distance away. I proffered my resignation on the basis that I did not believe the organizational mission. And after resigning from the church, I obviously lost that position as well. So I don't know. I think he later told me that, you know, he basically was forced to resign because he was going to lose his job either way, you know. And then he says, knowing the church office of general counsel, they are going to subpoena Reddit, LinkedIn, Facebook, etc. I appreciate your help. I really do. I just wish I could explain it better. These people are masochists. They are nefarious. I can't reveal my identity. And in fact, I've gone to great lengths to avoid social media. I don't have LinkedIn or Facebook. I do not have a phone because I have no money. I do not know how to make you confident, but I can assure you this is the real deal. I would not be wasting my time and energy on this if it wasn't. I totally understand where you're coming from on this. So then I ask, well, how would I get the money to you? And he says, transfer the funds through Bitcoin. And then I say, man, I just don't see it happening. I have built up too much of a reputation to blow it on a mistake like this. If you change your mind about talking to me, let me know. And then he responds, not wanted by Mormons or ex-Mormons. Got it. And then I said, I'm sorry you feel that way. I can assure you that that is not the case. We try to help people at the Underground Handcart Company. So I was going to use sort of the Underground Handcart Company as the platform of raising money for him. Then he says, messages back, I have been up since last night uploading these documents and dealing with abuse on Reddit. This is not exactly fun, I am telling you. This is the real deal. My stomach is grumbling. I feel like blank. I'm scared out of my mind. I don't know what else to do. I guess neither do I. This is what I respond. I owe it to any potential donor to do some due diligence if I am going to solicit donations and vouch for you. Surely you can see how unwise it would be for me to vouch for an anonymous Redditor. And then he says, I don't know what else to say. Thank you for your concern, but I will not have my freedom or anonymity jeopardized. And I respond, good luck to you. Let me know if there's anything I can do in the future. Cheers. So then I don't know when, but later, I had kind of messaged a couple people, you know, without telling him I was going to do it, just kind of like saying, hey, you know, would you even be willing to donate to a guy in this situation where I really can't, you know, do much vouching for him? And I actually got a couple people saying that they would donate some money. So I wrote him back. I don't know if it was like the next day or something. And I said, hey, are you still there? I have been speaking with a couple of people that I trust about this situation. I may be having a change of heart. Let me know if you're still reading this message. And then I said, I've already raised over $100. And then he says, I am. He's still looking at it. Sorry, I had to take a break. This is incredibly overwhelming. I understand. This is what I said. I understand. How do I get the money to you when I am ready to send it? I know nothing about Bitcoin. And then he tells me how to do Bitcoin. Okay. And then I say, and then I just deposited an account number, and yes, and then he gives me the account number. And then I said, we're up to $1,100. So I made a GoFundMe, and I promoted it on through my Underground Handcart Facebook page. And at this point, I mean, within a really quick period, we got $1,100. And he says, amazing. And it's gaining traction in the press, finally. And he refers to some articles about the documents he released. And he says, Gizmodo and Mashable have reached out to me, but I have not responded to any media entity. I don't want to talk to the press. And then I say, if you ever want to talk to the press, let me know. I can help you with that. I don't want to read this whole thing. It goes on and on and on. And then I said, it's going to take me a couple days to get the money into my account, then to you. Right now, we are at 1,110 minus the GoFundMe fees. Okay, and then he says he's going to talk to me over talking to the press, and he'll let me go through the press. And it's like, it's all about transparency is what he says. Then he says, you are an amazing human being. I really hope we meet to meet you someday when all this dies down. Thank you so much. And then I kind of jokingly said, definitely, I'm in Las Vegas. You can come buy me a drink. And I put a little smiley face. Okay, so then I give a little later, I send him a status. Here's a status update. I just withdrew what donations are so far. After the GoFundMe fees, it is it's a little over $1,000. It can take up to 5 days to hit my account. And then I said, I confront you some of it now. How much do you need for the next couple of days? He said, Ryan, you are truly a saint by definition. Whatever, and I'm not reading these, you know, to like impress you guys. I want to read some of these where he's like complimenting me just to sort of really set the table for what happens later. He says, whatever you can do would be phenomenal. As I've said, I have absolutely nothing. I am so hungry that my fingers are shaking, and I'm typing this because I've been doing nothing. But I'm sorry. Let me restart this over. I am so hungry that my fingers are shaking as I am typing this because I've been doing nothing but uploading and typing all day. So I think I'm going to take another break. But anything you can do would be above and beyond what I expected. I'm trying to do the right thing, but it's very scary. I know it will give people the truth. And I said, okay, I will send you 300 for now. Now, just to be clear, the only reason I was only sending him 300, even though I had $1,000 and change sent to me, is because it hadn't come into my account yet. So this initial 300, I was basically fronting with my own money. And those that know me in real life know that I don't have a lot of money. I'm not a rich guy. And so I told him I would front him $300 until I got the rest of the money. Okay. So I signed up for Bitcoin. I said, I just need to figure out how to put the money in my wallet. Thank you. And then he says, thank you so much. What should my next step be? And here's what I said. If you have a legit leak that is newsworthy, my guy says you can work with him anonymously. This was a journalist that I was talking to about him. If you just have the same type of stuff you've been posting, which is good, but not really national news, then let's get it aggregated somewhere and post it all at once, nice and clean, with no traces to you. Okay. My journalist guy might also be interested in your personal story, not just the contents of the leak. He is going to get back to me in the morning. And then I tell him I'm having some trouble with Bitcoin. Those that have done Bitcoin, when you first sign up, you've got to like prove who you are with your driver's license and stuff. So that all took me like probably 12 hours to get that all done. All right, so let me kind of skip down to some important stuff. He's saying, oh, I appreciate it. Okay, I'll be home. I'll be home in an hour. I'll get you the 300 ASAP. And then I say, okay, I transferred 300. They withheld $11 in fees. It says it will hit my wallet tomorrow morning. So this was getting $300 into my Bitcoin. Okay. And then I transferred it to him. I said, money sent, please confirm that you got it. And then he says, Ryan, I received it. Thank you so much. I have a pounding headache and don't know how much work I'll get done today because I feel horrible, but all the work you've done on my behalf is fantastic. Again, thank you. I will try to get past this rut and continue with what I need to do. Do you have a link to the GoFundMe? That way I can send it to inquiring people. Thank you. And I send them the link. Okay. Thank you, Ryan. What is your schedule like today? My schedule is very flexible. What are you thinking? That's what I said to him. I was wondering if you had some time, if you could create a zip file of documents that I've already leaked and posted. I also can you select the top five most interesting documents that we can send to the press? Thank you. And I said, yes, we should do that. In fact, someone I work with closely is already gathering your docs in a zip file. What I think would be more helpful is a master document that summarizes what each doc has. How many more do you have to leak? And he says, honestly, I don't know. I am shifting through. This is important. Okay. Listen very carefully. He says, I'm sifting through thousands of files and uploading only the stuff that I consider to be of interest to the XML community. Okay. He clearly says he has thousands of files. It's going to be something that comes up later on as we go. And I said, so it's safe to say that you might have a nugget in there that you don't even have yet. And he says, yes. Okay, and I said, here's what I think you should do. We should do. Keep in mind that not only are you going about this in a very inefficient manner, if you stumble onto something big after 200 leaks of mundane stuff, the important one might not have the same impact. I have a guy who I work with closely with on these types of things. He's a computer and big data whiz. If we can set up a way for me and him to have access to all these files, we can spend the next couple of days cataloging everything. We do a massive dump on Sunday or Monday, and we have all the juiciest parts highlighted. I think we can do this without me knowing who you are. Also, now remember, this is before my website, by the way, so I'm somewhat speaking on the fly here. But also, if you do find something super juicy, we can take the necessary precautions to further protect your identity. Doing it piecemeal like this is just not an effective way to go. Okay, I'll finish uploading what I do have sorted already, and then I'll get the rest of you. And then he says he's going to get the rest of me. Okay. So then he kind of goes into this whole big financial situation that he has. He says, I got $1,500 due in rent on October 1st. I also have $372 medical bill, $147 car payment, car insurance, $120 car payment. I don't have a cell phone. Blah, 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 blah. He's going on and on about his money situation. He says at the end, if I could ask for an amount, it would be $3,500 to get me through September and October until I could get my first paycheck. Okay. And I respond, I said, I can pretty much guarantee you $2,000. I have a guy who is going to make sure the GoFundMe gets to that amount, at least. Beyond that, I can make no promises. As for the docs, let me talk to my computer guy and figure out the most secure, confidential way to do this document exchange. And by the way, this is not privacy P. Pratt that I'm referring to. And he says, thank you on both accounts. All right. Let me go and skip because some of this stuff is just really nothing that has anything to do with it. Okay. All right. So then I said, okay, I set up a Google, I emailed him. I said, or I sent him a message. I said, okay, I set up a Gmail account with a really strong password. And, I said, I'll give you the password and then you can dump the Google Drive or the documents into the Google Drive and you can give them to me that way. And then he says, okay, I need to take some time off the computer. I have a migraine. I'll do this later. I said, sounds good. Let me know. And then I said, we're up to $1,275. I give him a little update. Okay. So then he says that he tried to sell some Bitcoin and got scammed out of some Bitcoin. Whatever. And I said, and he's asking me if I, you know, oh, he says, I'm getting a lot of nasty, horrible messages, even death threats. I said, I have no idea. Can't you transfer the money into your bank account? He said, once you get me the docs, this is what I say. Once you get me the docs, you can rest for days. I will take over the heavy lifting. Your identity will never be found out from me. And he said, I literally have, and I mentioned a couple of media outlets that are interested in case you have something juicy. All right. All right, I'm going to try to find. Okay, so here we go. Here we go. Okay, so you're never going to believe what happened, he says to me. I said, what? He goes, I was served with a restraining order preventing me from entering my own home. The bishop showed up. Now, he also made a post about this. Okay. Showed up with, or maybe I made a post because he told me to. I can't remember which one it was, but we made a post about this. Bishop showed up with the police and everything. They didn't even give me a chance to get my property. They just let me take some clothes. My life is destroyed. And then he says, I don't think we need more than 50 gigs. Are we sure Google is not going to find this, feed this to anybody? And then he writes, well, I'm homeless now. I have church security contacting family members. I have a whole, I was a high profile employee that, well, okay, maybe I shouldn't. He mentioned some stuff he did with his job, which I don't even know if I believe, but whatever. And I asked him, is this because of the leak? Like, did they find out you were the leak, or is this issues with your wife? And he says it's a combination of both, maybe. But he says it's mostly his wife. His wife went to the stake president, blah, blah, blah. He claims she painted him as a bad guy, whatever. Whatever. Let's see. Here's an interesting thing. And this is why I think this guy is lying. I'm reading some of these messages for the first time in a really long time. He's talking about how his wife was able to get this restraining order or whatever, getting kicked out of the house. She says, my spouse, bishop, and stake president had a meeting, and they basically said she deserves the house. And the judge, who is the stake president's brother-in-law, issued the order. I need to get an attorney. This is a nightmare. Now, that sure sounds like he's talking about like a Utah issue, right? I mean, where else would a bishop and a stake president get this involved in a divorce dispute? And it just so happens that the brother-in-law is a judge who would have the authority to issue this order. Right. This all sounds like something that could only happen like in Utah or, you know, parts of Idaho or something like this, or maybe Las Vegas. Well, I found out later that he claims to not even be in anywhere near any of these states. And he claims to live and had worked for the church in a state that has no Mormons in it. I mean, statistically has no Mormons in it. So I'm reading this now and I'm realizing that there's no way this is true. There's no way that he had a stake president who just happened to have a brother-in-law who was a judge who in the very sort of, you know, 12th hour, you know, issues this order. I'm not buying it. Oh, and here he goes. Oh, next message from him. The government has the church operatives embedded. I have personal knowledge of that. Now, I don't know if that's true or not. But if it is true, it's only true in Utah. It's not true in the state. But you know what? I'm going to say what state he was in. He says he's in New York City or New York. I don't know if it's New York City, but either in New York City or the surrounding area. There is no way that what he just said is happening in the state of New York. My spouse, bishop, and stake president had a meeting, and they basically said she deserved the house, and the judge, who is the stake president's brother-in-law, issued the order. I need to get an attorney. This is a nightmare. The government has church operatives embedded. I have personal knowledge of this. That's not happening in New York. And this supposedly happened in New York. Okay. If you're wondering why I'm giving up some of this information, it's because of all the lies and the backstabbing that you're about to see. Okay. And I said to him, okay, I will front you another $300. I still haven't received the money from GoFundMe yet. I said, get a cheap motel and call me. And then he says, I'm going to an SBUX. I'm not sure what that means. I think he went to like an extended stay place. I'll get a burner phone, then I'll get a motel. Then I'll call you, whatever. He says, Let me get down to some juicy stuff. Oh, he says, I almost feel like I need to leave the country. I do not feel safe anymore. What type of phone should I get? I cannot be traced. Also, I should probably retain an attorney to get access to my property back. Is there any way you can incorporate a legal fund for me into GoFundMe? I am really putting my neck out there and I need backup. Please advise. I have no problem setting up a legal fund. Let's do these docs first. Let's get these docs exchanged first. See, I wanted to make sure this guy was like legit, right? Before I really, really dove in. Okay. And I said, as far as the phone goes, just go to Walmart and get one of those pay-as-you-go phones. That's what I said. And then he didn't respond to me for a while. I said, is everything okay? And then again, a little later, I said, where are we at with everything? If you still want to move forward with my proposal, we need to make it happen sooner rather than later. If you want to pursue other options, let me know and I will back off. If you want me to come meet you in person, I will. Because I'm assuming he's in Utah at this point, based on everything he's saying. I was going to drive up to Utah if needed and pick this guy up and bring him to Las Vegas or whatever. I was ready to do that. So then he says, I'm sorting through the remaining documents. Part of what I need to do is remove my token from the encryption file. And he says, let's see. So then he says, last night's rate was $120 at his hotel, and that's the cheapest in the area. Where are we at with the GoFundMe? And I said, is there a cheap extended stay place you can go to? And he goes, okay, let me try to dig out. Hang on here. Oh, he says, there is an extended stay place. The going rate is $139 a night. It's on the outskirts of where I live, and then $159 a night if I want to be close to civilization. And I'm trying to see because I know at some point I said you need to come to Las Vegas because there's cheaper extended stays. Again, I'm thinking he's in Utah. Oh, and then I asked him, I asked him if I could use PayPal to send him money on PayPal because it's cheaper than Bitcoin. He said, no, he doesn't want to use Bitcoin. Okay. So at this point, the chat moves over to Skype. He randomly contacts me on Skype. Oh no, he asked me. He asked me, here it is in the Reddit. He asked me, can we talk on Skype? Which, I mean, I wouldn't really want to do that, but he wanted to do Skype, so I gave him my Skype handle. He messages me. Now, we had thousands of interaction on Skype, thousands of back and forth comments. Now, I don't know if he's gone and deleted that chat. I don't know. The chat is gone. I went on there yesterday wanting to, preserve that chat so that I could talk about it today and preserve it, and it's gone. And I tried to Google how to retrieve it and stuff, and nothing is working. I cannot retrieve this chat. So I'm going to tell you guys how it went based on my memory. We start talking, and he starts telling me, all these, crazy conspiracies of stuff that's going on behind the scenes at the church that he's going to help expose. And I'm like, okay, I mean, this stuff he's telling me is like craziness, right? And then he uploads pretty quickly after we start talking on Skype, he uploads a zip file to me that has a couple hundred documents in it. And I still have that zip file. And he says, this is what I've cleaned so far. And he reiterates to me what he already said in the Reddit about how he has thousands more documents that we still need to go through. I said, okay, well, let's start with these couple hundred. And all of the ones he had already released were in there. And then there were some other ones that he hadn't released. And we're going through some of them, and some of them seem pretty interesting or whatever. Nothing like earth shattering or whatever. So we're talking back and forth, and I get a hold. Let me take a step back for a second. While all of this is happening, okay, I start we had kind of put a thing out on Reddit about how we were working together, and so people should just calm down for a minute, and then we would, you know, in a couple of weeks, we would make a message about, you know, what's going on, because people on Reddit were going crazy with all of these leaks that he kept dumping. And as a result of all of this attention that he got, and I was now getting on Reddit because people knew I was helping him, I got contacted by a lot of people, a lot more people than I was normally getting contacted. And those of you who've heard me give interviews recently have heard me say something like, at some point in October, whatever, September, October, I was getting bombarded. One of the reasons was because I released those videos, but I was even getting a little bombarded before the videos because of my association with Mormon Documents. And one of the people that contacted me was the person with the videos. And they said, you know, hey, you know, I like what you're doing with Mormon Documents, trying to help him out. You know, maybe you can help me out here with these videos, blah, blah. And well, you know, as far as those videos goes, the rest is history. I'm not going to get into that. But when I released the videos the following day, Monday, after I'd already given several interviews, I was contacted by Lori. What's her last name? I think it's Goldstein. I chat with her every once in a while now too, but I just call her Lori. I don't remember her last name. Goldstein, I believe it is. And she's the main religion writer for the New York Times. And she wanted to do a story on these videos, which she did. And I also told her about Mormon Documents and about how I was working with him and that we would eventually have thousands of documents, that there was probably, and he was claiming that these, I remember now, he was claiming that once he got me these documents, that they would paint a very clear picture that the church was sending 100% of tithing money to a company called Ensign Peak Advisors, which is a for-profit entity, and they were then investing that money and doing whatever they do, you know, investments or whatever, and then they would control the church's budget. And so he was making the claim that Ensign Peak Advisors would give the church just only the money they needed to operate, and that's it. And they had the church on a budget, and that Ensign Peak was actually controlling the funds. This was his claim. And he claimed that in these thousands of documents, that picture would be able to be clearly painted without a doubt. So I'm telling Lori from the New York Times this, and she says, you know, well, if we get these documents and they seem like they're legit, you know, we can do investigation on our end, and we can have a team of people that, you know about this financial stuff and can help look at it and help put it together, blah, 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 blah. So I'm going back and forth between Lori over the next couple of days, between Lori and between Mormon Documents, and I'm saying, listen, New York Times is interested. They can do this. And so we came up with this whole thing. I worked it out with Lori. She gave me the mailing address, and he was going to put these thousands of documents onto a thumb drive. He was going to then overnight them to me, and then I was going to overnight them to Lori. Now, he was on board with this. He says, yes, I'll do it in the morning. Okay. And this is why. And of course, there were always things that delayed it. And he always kept saying, yes, I'm going to send the thumb drive. He strung that out for several weeks. But if for those that remember me saying in messages somewhat cryptically about how I was working with Mormon Documents and the New York Times to get something done, this is what I was talking about. Okay. He agreed to send this thumb drive, and the New York Times agreed to look into it. And so that was what we were doing. And I was simply just waiting for him to send me this thumb drive, and New York Times was going to, you know, take over from there, and maybe they find something and maybe they don't. Well, of course, he never sent this thumb drive. Okay. In the meantime, we're going back and forth, and he tells me, he says, I got to drop a bomb on you. And I said, okay, this is on Skype, so I can't read you the messages. So I'm just telling you from my memory. He says, I got a friend who's a closet, you know, non-believer. He still works at the church, blah, 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 blah. Higher up than I was. And he goes to Germany all the time. And I'm telling you this because it's not going to identify anybody, because I'm 100% sure that he's lying about this. I realized later. But I'm believing him in the moment. He goes, this guy has to go for church business all the time to Germany and stuff like that. And he says, he can go to Germany this weekend during General Conference. And he can go there without raising suspicion, because you can just, you know, he goes there all the time for business. And he can go while everybody's watching General Conference and nobody's at the office. He can go and access documents, and There's one particular set of documents he's going to get that is going to prove X. Now, I'm not going to say what X is, although Mormon documents told me what that is. I'm not going to say what it is because, I mean, there's a very, very much outside chance that it's true. But in the event that it's not true, this is something that is so salacious that if I were to say it right now, it would create this whole big speculation online about whether or not this could be true, and people would blog about it, and people would say, yes, it's unconfirmed, but here's the rumor, and I don't even want to start that. But what I will tell you is this. If X were true and it could be proven, it would be the biggest story in the history of the Mormon Church. And I am not exaggerating. So, of course, when he tells me this, I'm thinking, wow. And it's bigger than what he later claimed to have with, you know, this audio of the 12 acting like they know the church isn't true, which I'll talk about in a minute. It's bigger than that. Okay. So I'm like, wow, of course I'm getting excited here, you know, like for the possibilities. And, you know, so far, I mean, think about this. I mean, he's come through with all these documents. He's sent me a zip file with hundreds of documents that all look really legit. And so I'm starting to believe him, you know, and you know, he drops this on me, and I mean, I'm believing him. So then he says, he goes, oh, I remember he said something like, oh, this guy doesn't want to do it unless I go with him, but I don't have the money. And I thought, okay, I'm going to do a pause real quick. Take care of my son. Okay. Sorry about that. My 4-year-old had to go to the bathroom and I had to help him with that. Okay, so, you know, he drops this little hint. Now, he didn't ask for money, but I kind of had this, like, suspicion that he was kind of going down that path of, like, let's see if we can get money for me to go with him. He was claiming that this guy, you know, was really nervous and he needed the moral support. And as a matter of cutting it off at the pass, I said, well, there's no way we're going to be able to raise money for you to go to Europe. I mean, there's no way. I said something like, I'm not even going to ask people for that. And so he goes, and then he responded back like, yeah, no, I know that. There's no way that would happen. So, you know, he says, oh yeah, there's no way it would happen. We kind of just moved on from that. And, you know, so this is like a couple days, before conference, and, you know, I hadn't even released the videos yet. Okay. I hadn't even gotten the videos yet. So, I know I've already talked about the videos, but just keep in mind, like, all this stuff was sort of like intertwined. So this is like a couple days before a conference, and he's like, oh, you know, the guy doesn't know if he wants to do it or whatever. And I'm just like, hey, look, man, I don't know who this guy is. I'm not talking to this guy. I said, if he wants to call me and, you know, I mean, I can talk to him if he wants somebody to talk to. I said, but he either does it or he doesn't. It is what it is. And I said, you know, I mean, if it's really what you're saying it is, I said, I mean, he probably should do the right thing. Because, I mean, it was that big of a thing, which, I mean, it's not even true. So I don't even want to think about it too much about what it is these guys are claiming. But so anyway, we're chatting back and forth. I'm still sending him Bitcoin as I get the money on the GoFundMe. As it's hitting my account, I'm sending him the Bitcoin. And he says, oh, my friends, he's going to do it. You know, this is like, you know, Thursday or Friday or whatever. He's like, he's getting on a plane tonight. He's going to Germany. Okay, whatever, you know, so he goes to, supposedly his friend's going to Germany. Now, I'm believing it at the time. I'm like, okay, you know, this is exciting, and, you know, let's see what happens or whatever. And, you know, over like Saturday and Sunday, he's like texting me saying, oh, he's texting me right now. He's like, he's at the building right now, and he's going through stuff, and he says, oh, he got it. He's got the paperwork. And I mean, it's not like he's saying these things intermittent with our other chatting, right? He's like, oh, hey, the guy just, he just texted me and said, you know, he's got everything. You know, he got the documents he wanted or whatever that would prove X, right? So I said, okay, this is great. Oh, he'll be back on Tuesday. He's coming back Tuesday, whatever. So again, we're still doing Bitcoin. And I'm telling you guys, me getting him this Bitcoin, I was jumping through hoops to get him this Bitcoin because it was extremely difficult for me to get Bitcoin into my Bitcoin, because, you know, when you're a new Bitcoin user, they have limits on how much Bitcoin you can buy. And so you have to go, and once you reach your limit, you have to go buy Bitcoins out on the open market. And it's extremely difficult to do. I was buying Bitcoin from people in like Pakistan. I bought Bitcoin from somebody in Palestine. This is a great story. Somebody in Palestine. And so I have to like wire this person. They have like this open market of Bitcoin. You know, you guys, so those that have done it, they know what I'm talking about. It's like a stock market type thing. So you find people that are selling Bitcoin for the price you agree to and whatever. And, you know, you send them the money different ways. So I'm sending this guy money through Western Union. And he sends me the Western Union instructions. And he says, and, you know, you have to, he has to give the address or whatever, his address. And so he gives me his address. And for country, it says Palestine. And he puts in the message, he says, if you put Israel, I will reject the money. So I'm like, and I'm thinking, oh my goodness, who am I dealing with there? Am I like helping fund terrorism or something? You know, and I have no idea, but you know, it was just some Palestinian that didn't want me to put Israel as his address. So these are these crazy hoops that I'm jumping it through, get him this money that people send me. I'm like sending him at this point, like I send him like, I get him like around $2,000 before the donations start. Maybe it was a little over 2,000 before the donations started to dry up. And I sent him all that money minus fees. And I probably sent him more than that. I was probably out of money in my own pocket, which I was trying to avoid because I don't really can't afford it, but whatever. So here comes, he's supposed to go and meet this guy. Oh, before this happens. Let me try to remember. I can't remember what happened first. So I'll tell this. I think this happened first. So he says to me, he goes, I found a place to live. But the guy wants, the landlord wants first and last month's rent. And it was going to be like $1,500 or something. And he's like, yeah. I said, well, get PayPal and I'll send, hang on, let me think. Yeah. So he goes, I need first and last month's rent. And I don't, you know, I'm already almost out of the money you sent me because of the hotel room every night and food and blah, 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 blah. And I said, look, man, I put my neck out so much. And I said, where's the thousands of documents? I kept saying, you know, send me this thumb drive. You know, and of course, we're waiting for him to meet with his friend, too, for this stuff from Germany. So I'm feeling bad for this guy. I'm believing him. So I contact somebody who's an ex-Mormon who participates on Reddit. I'm not going to say who he is for his own privacy, but he's a rich guy, and I knew he was a rich guy. Now, I didn't realize how rich he was. I found out later the guy's like, he's got a lot of money, and he's a great guy, and if he's listening to this, you know, I enjoy all my interactions with him. We still communicate from time to time. I reach out to this guy and I'm very apologetic. I mean, I'm really going outside of my comfort zone at this point. And I say something like, listen, this guy, he had told me, Mormon Documents had told me that he got the landlord to agree to just first month's rent. So he needed $1,500, but he's, you know, and I said, listen, I said to my contact, I said, look, this guy's in this situation. He's about to start a job in like 5 days, whatever, you know, whenever it was. And I'm like, you know, if there's any way you can help me get close to this $1,500, you know, this would be great. And the guy sends me $2,000 on PayPal. And I just, I started to cry, like literally, like my eyes teared up because I mean, you got to think in the moment I am like totally believing this guy and I'm thinking, man, I got to help this guy. And you know, this is going to be all for a greater good. And I mean, I feel embarrassed to even ask for this money. And here's this guy who's at this point is pretty much a stranger to me. We've barely interacted. And here he sends me $2,000. And I just, man, it was an emotional moment. And I sent him the money and, you know, he said, thank you and all this stuff. So then he's supposed to meet with this guy. Okay. He goes, I'm going to meet with this guy, Thursday. And, he'd been telling me he wasn't feeling well. Okay. But then he says, you know, he's going to go meet with this guy like on a Thursday. This is like the Thursday after conference, something like this. And he's going to give me the file, the thumb drive with all these documents or whatever it was, whatever the form. I don't know if it was hard copies or a thumb drive or what it was. So I said, okay. So I remember that he texts me like at 5 o'clock at Las Vegas time or whatever time it was. And he says, I'm on my way. I'm leaving to the meeting. You know, he's supposedly communicating to me via computer. So when he leaves the apartment, you know, I can't communicate with him until he gets back or whatever, or from the hotel. And maybe at this point he'd already moved into that apartment with the money I sent him. So he goes, I'm leaving. I'll get back to you when I get back. And I'm like, I'm literally like, I'm shaking. And I had, I teach class here at CSN at the local community college. And, I had class that night and I'm like, couldn't even get it off of my mind. I'm like so distracted. I'm giving a lecture up there. And in the back of my mind, I'm thinking about this whole mess and about how like we might be about to make history, you know, if this guy comes through. So all of a sudden I don't hear from him for like 3 days. 3 days, nothing. I'm emailing him. I'm like, what's going on? What's all on Skype. Like I'm texting him. What's going on? Where are you at? And I'm like just freaking out. I'm like, oh my goodness, I was scammed. So then he, out of the blue, he says, oh, I'm in the hospital. I convinced the nurse to lend me her phone and use Skype to contact you, which now that I think about it, it's probably not true. But he goes, yeah, you know, I told you I was sick and wasn't feeling well. It turns out I have pneumonia or whatever it was he said he had. And he goes, I showed up to my meeting with my friend and he told me I looked like crap and that he wasn't going to do anything until I went to the hospital. And he drove me immediately to the hospital. I'm like, okay. I said, did he give you the documents? And he goes, no. I was completely out of it by the time he got to the hospital. And he's like, you know, he'll give them to me once I get better. He's like, give me a couple of days. So then a couple of days pass. And then he goes, you know, oh, my guy won't give them to me or something. I don't remember what he said to me. And then I don't hear from him. Weeks go by. And I'm like, what's going on? And I'm texting like once a week, I'll text him on Skype. Hey, what's going on? Update, blah, blah, blah. So finally I wrote this big, long message to him. At this point, I'm convinced, you know, we got scammed. He got over $4,000, okay, total. And I figured, you know, this guy was, he was really an ex-Mormon. Maybe he's not. Somehow he got into, maybe he worked for the church, maybe he didn't. I don't know. Somehow he got a hold of these documents, you know, you know, decided to use, maybe he's an ex-Mormon, he's just a bad guy, and he's, you know, trying to scam us out of money. He got $4,000, and he ran away. So I wrote him this big, long message on Skype, which I wish I had. I would love to read it to you guys, and I just blasted him, and I'm like, I put my neck out for you. I contacted this rich guy that I know that I didn't even have to contact this guy. I put my neck out on the line for you. Now I have egg on my face, and you know, now I might have burned a bridge with this, you know, with this rich guy, which by the way I didn't. He was really, you know, he's still been really cool with me, and I think, you know, he sees it as he was helping a guy, you know, that needed help or whatever. So I just go off and I told him, and I mean I was cursing and I let him have it, and I told him, you know, I said some really strong, really bad stuff. Okay. So then let me go to what happened then. Now, many of you know, he shows up one day back in, I don't know, November, December, you know, whenever it was. Okay. Oh, no, before he goes on to Reddit. So he contacts me completely out of the blue. Okay. Not on Skype. He contacts me on Reddit. He says, please contact me ASAP, urgent. This is like weeks after I sent him that final message. And I go, what? How do you want me to contact you? Reddit? And then he says, I had a stroke. And I said, okay. And then I said, did you get my last message on Skype? And he says, no, I did not. Then he said, maybe in a bit I will copy and paste it. The bottom line is that you, by completely disappearing just after I completed giving you thousands of dollars, have put me in a position where I must tread lightly. If you had a stroke, I am sorry to hear that. But right now, that is of no concern to me because you cannot prove to me that it happened. What is the status of the 1,000 docs and the stuff about X that he was supposedly had from Germany? I don't want to say what I said here. And he goes, now this is important. He says, I have it, but you're not getting S if you're effing rude to me. I precipitated the video leaks and played a part in getting you more press coverage. don't effing bite the hand that feeds you. Now, that was a pretty strong message from him. All right. So then I said, I'm not being rude. You put yourself in my place. Or I'm sorry. I said, put yourself in my place. But anyway, you tell me what's next. Surely you're not saying that the videos were all credit to you, whatever. And then he says to me, you're being a huge dick. F you. And I said, fine. So are you. This is a two-way street. Don't act like I have done nothing for you. And right after I give you thousands of dollars that I stuck my neck out for you to get, you disappear. Tell me how I'm supposed to feel. Please tell me. That's what I say to him. And then he says, for the second time, I had a stroke. I was discharged from the hospital yesterday. Otherwise, why on earth would I stop talking to you? And I said, fine, I accept that. Are you okay now? Is there long-term damage? Did you lose your job? And then he says, that hurt. I think he read my Skype thing. And he says, oh, that hurt. I think he misspelled something here. I know I have to be anonymous, but I'm still a person that has feelings. I can't control what happened medically. I do not have a job, but I have to work. I have to be out of work for at least a month. It's not an ideal situation. I partially lost movement on my right side. And then I said, this is a high stress situation for all of us. I just hope you can see how things might look from my end. I am willing to put what I said aside for now. Let's go back to what's important. What is our next move? Okay. I'm still wanting these thousands of documents from him. Honestly, I don't even care about the Germany stuff anymore because I really don't even believe it's real, but I still am believing that he has thousands of documents. Okay. Let me see if I can go back to what he did then. So he, let's see. So he shows up, like, I don't hear from him again for another couple days, right? I'm going to the top of this message thing. And he goes on one day, as many of you will remember this. Okay. Oh, I emailed him again. I said, because I didn't hear from him for a couple days. I said, hey, what's our status? Do you need more time to take care of your health issues? What kind of timetable are you talking to? Do you think for talking to the New York Times about your docs? I am getting a lot of PMs in the last couple of days wanting an update. Okay. So then I still don't hear from him for a couple of days. Then he responds to this, but I didn't see the message right away. Okay. Cause it happened to be on a day that I was really busy with work and I'm about to go start my class at the community college. And I get a phone call from a blocked number and I answer the phone and I simply hear, check your Reddit. I'm like, okay. So I check Reddit and there was this private message from him from several hours earlier in the day. This is what he says. Here's the deal. We've reached the inner sanctum of the church's mainframe and we know how to access it without being traced due to planned downtime. What does this mean we have access to? The budget of the Quorum of the 12, salaries, transactions, but all of this pales in comparison to this. We have an audio recording of apostles discussing what is internally known as Olympus Quorum. It discusses the church's goals from the beginning as a planned world order of justice and peace, and using Jesus Christ as a pawn to achieve the ends of world control. The apostles take a blood oath to defend the church while under the direction of a shadow leadership. The shadow leadership still exists. I have the apostles speaking with the shadow leadership and they state unequivocally that the church is false. The apostles are the public facing leaders. The shadow leadership operates in extreme secrecy in Germany, which is where the church's most extremely sensitive documents are kept. My source can only download and transmit and send the information internally. The only time he can secure the information is by circumventing the internal firewall between the hours of 8 p.m. Mountain Standard Time and 12 a.m. Mountain Standard Time this Saturday when the servers don't have a direct link to Salt Lake so that he won't be traced. He wants 7,500 euros to be given to him in exchange for the information. I have not seen all the documents, but I have heard the audio. The apostles, the one I heard were Oakes, Ballard, Bednar, and Nelson, are heard discussing with the shadow leadership the fact that the Book of Mormon is a fraudulent document. Some general authorities are paid off to keep quiet once they are given emeritus status. That foreign and domestic, this is what they're discussing. So they're discussing the Book of Mormon thing, that some general authorities are paid off in emeritus status, that foreign and domestic government agents are paid off to give information, including state secrets, to the apostles. And most importantly, that the church is not true, but promotes what they consider to be a decent life for all, and it is better for them to keep up the act for the benefit of themselves and the world. One thing Nelson said verbatim is that the church is wrong about only one thing, and that is that it's history. But ultimately, the world will be better off because of us. We have no idea who the shadow leadership is, but they have obvious Utah accents from what I can decipher. The only other sounds I could decipher are European sirens, most likely from an ambulance, whatever that means. This is it. The world is counting on you. My source wants the money by midnight tomorrow night, midnight mountain time. The only thing I will say is that you know who he is. He's a general authority and has the requisite access to log in and secure the information. He will securely transmit it to me, and then I will mail it to you on a flash drive. I am awaiting his instructions once he receives his part of the bargain. We have a little more than 24 hours to get this done, and then the deal is permanently off, according to my source. I am not making the rules right now. I don't have the energy to deal with this, but I am making it happen somehow. After this becomes breaking news across the globe by the end of next week, he is strategically doing this after the election. He will publicly denounce the church and name the two members of the shadow leadership of the church, which he personally knows, and will go on the record. Together, we will destroy the fraudulent church. Olympus will fall. Okay. So I'm reading this. He sent it to me like several hours previous. And then I go onto Reddit and I find out that he posted, not this verbatim, but he posted about this in some more generalities in a Reddit post asking for the money and saying that he and I were working together on this. Yet I'm just finding out about this. So, still before I find out about the Reddit post, I said, okay, I took a minute to read this before my class starts. Obviously, it's very intriguing. And then I say, I see no way to get the money up front, especially by tomorrow night. I can promise you that I will do aggressive fundraising after the fact and get the money that way. I will reach out to a couple of people tonight and see if they have other ideas, but I don't see this happening, at least not the way you are proposing it here. And he says, it is not up to me. These are his conditions. Talk to Tyler Glenn or someone with money that wants to expose the church as a fraud. We need to get this done. If I had the money, I would do it myself. The source will not budge. He needs to expose the church for the fraud that it is. And we need to abide by his demands in order to do this service to anyone who is still believing in this fraud. We may not have this chance ever again. Ever. His words, not mine. So here we go. I have my class, and then I message him. Okay, class is over. This is what I'm saying to him. I am going to be driving here, so additional reply might be in a bit. Here is my message for your guy. I totally understand the desire for financial compensation, even if I will be able to arrange something, which I doubt. There is no way it is happening in the next day or two. I want him to think about something. Based on what you are telling me, we have scandalous information that would come closer to bringing down the church than anything ever seen up to this point. He needs to man up and do the right thing. I'm being totally serious. The right thing to do is to get this information out in the open. Remember that we have access to a whistleblower lawyer. That's another thing I forgot. I contacted a whistleblower lawyer for this guy and got some advice from him. That all happened in the Skype chat. I said, remember, we have access to a whistleblower lawyer who can help if there are criminal acts being exposed. But even if it's just exposing unethical behavior, the right thing to do is to get it out there. The money will come. I will do aggressive fundraising. Plus, there will surely be media opportunities for him, up to and including a book deal. I realize he thinks he is putting everything on the line and risking everything, but think of it like this. He will be celebrated by everyone but a select few Uber TBMs that will decide to stick with the church. This will not hurt his overall reputation. In my opinion, it will actually open doors. And the bottom line is, tell him I said he needs to do the right thing and expose this corruption, if it's true. As for the money, I don't see any path to getting the money right now. Okay. So then he says, pass your message on to the source. Here is his response. This is the last planned downtime for 2016. I do it now or never because they are upgrading the IT infrastructure for the Europe area to track who accesses what and when in light of the recent leaks. Whoever releases this information after Saturday will be tracked and potentially hurt physically and definitely hurt in employment and other spheres of life. I need to get to a planned safe house with other general authorities as planned and avoid church security. You need to understand that this is the last opportunity we have to get this information. I need the finances untraced to my bank account to get to the safe house. This is, for instance, a hotel. From there, we can communicate and coordinate with media. I care about getting this out, but I need to protect myself. That comes first. Church security kills people. Yeah, whatever. Do we have proof of this? Yes. And I am not willing to get killed. Ever wonder what happened to Nicholas Barnes? Surreptitiously killed by CSD, that's Church Security Department, because he was going to expose the bribery and extortion committed by the LDS Church associated with the Olympic bid. I was in the room when GBH, Gordon B. Hinckley, ordered the killing. I shall not take that risk. I personally know from other murders committed by CSD and will not hesitate to talk about that, but I need to get to the safe house. This is non-negotiable. Change the world now or not at all. You have until midnight Saturday. I don't know what else to say. That's end of message. And he says, I don't know what else to say. He wants what he wants. I don't have the money to give him. Now, I am not believing this for a second. Now, this is what I said. I said, tell him to go pound sand. All this drama and he only wants $7,500 or euros? Seriously, only $7,500 and he is willing to risk his life? BS. Tell him to do the right thing and we can set up protection. If he can get stuff now, untraceable, we have time to set up safe houses. Hell, we could even do it before releasing it to the public. I will not, under any circumstance, raise money for this project as it stands now. I don't know anyone's identity and I have seen nothing. Then, after all of that, I see the Reddit post that he made saying that I was working with him that he made hours earlier before any of this conversation. And I said, why did you make that Reddit post? That's very irresponsible. And he said, I did as I was instructed. And I think I made a Reddit post saying that I was not in any way affiliated with this and I'm only hearing about it right now, blah, blah, blah. All right. So he said, I did his instruction. He's like, the ball's in your court. And I said, okay. And I messaged him, can we move on to you contacting, working in the New York Times with your thousands of documents? And he says, negative. I am loyal to the source. I told him I would do as he asked, and it doesn't seem like it's going to happen. He is putting himself on the line as I am. If you want to make history, now is your chance. Make this November to remember. And I said, really? So all those documents you have, they stay hidden unless your GA friend gets $7,500? Am I getting that right? That's what I asked him. And he says, let me put it this way. When he releases even just merely the audio I heard, we don't need to worry about the thousands of documents. Now, he's still acknowledging that he has thousands of documents. Important for later. Apostle saying the church is a fraud is enough to bring it down. It is up to us to make sure we do what he wants. He hasn't failed us up to now. No reason to believe he will in this instance. So I respond. I said, whatever. When you guys are ready to do the right thing, let me know. Now you are starting to hurt the projects I have in the works. Leaks where I actually know the leaker. See, at this point, I'm ramping up Mormon leaks. I said, leaks where I actually know the leaker's identities and where no money is being asked for. And don't think the other leaks aren't explosive because you would be wrong. Now what is going to happen when your guy doesn't come through and there is this post linked to me? Thanks a lot for that. I'm still talking about how he shouldn't have made this post with my name in it without even telling me. Okay. He goes, forget the New York Times. He's talking about sending the thousands of dollars. You will have BBC, NPR, MSNBC, Fox News, and others begging you to do video interviews. This will dwarf anything you or I have ever done or will ever do. And then I wrote to him, I now have people PMing me. You have been very irresponsible with your post. Please make a new post and let everybody know that I had nothing to do with it and that you may have overpromised. And then he said, I would wait till the morning to respond to your PMs. You may have a change of heart. Think of the implications. And I said, there is no change of heart to be had. 7,500 does not exist even if I wanted it to. 7,500 euros, that's less. It's less than 7,000. Just wait until the morning. Then tell me how you feel. You have until Saturday. And I said, sorry, dude, your exchange rate is wrong because it's actually 7,500 euros is more than $7,500. Not that it would make a difference. Less than 9,000 then. It's up to you. Bring the church down or don't. This is your chance. And then I say, or it is up to you guys to do the right thing. See how that works? Are you going to make a clarifying post? If not, I will need to. You really screwed up by making that post. You have put me in a horrible position. And then he says, you are jeopardizing the leak and my source is ready to kill me. Delete your post and I'll delete mine because I had just made this post about clarifying. And I said, ha, I am jeopardizing the leak. You were the one who made a post bringing me into this charade. This jeopardizes nothing because there will be no money. Tell your guy to go back to lying to people. Tell your guy to go back to lying to people and supporting a corrupt organization. Because I'm basically saying, hey, if he's not willing to do the right thing, then let him go and keep faking being a member. I am asking you to delete your post, please. I will delete mine, and then we can regroup and strategize from here. I want to work with you. Please, let's work together and start fresh. And I said, I see no reason to delete. Tell me how we would regroup. There is no money. I put no in capital. You said your docs and the audit are and the audio are contingent on the money. On top of all that, you put me in a situation where I was required to defend my reputation. You made a post with my name without telling me. If you want to talk, I suggest you call me like you did yesterday. He called me when he said, check Reddit. He says, I did what was told. Delete the post and we'll move on from here. There will be no radio silence. I'll be able to talk to you about the details. I understand your conditions. And I said, I am not deleting the post unless you give me a good reason to. As of now, there is no good reason. Because I think I'm able to sort this out with the source and convince him to release it without any funds being transacted. And I said, and how does my post jeopardize that? If anything, it helps. The church would read my post and think I am being scammed. Think about what happens when I delete the post. All hell will break loose. There is no one to blame on this but you. You made this mess. Now, if you can convince him, then so be it. My post has nothing to do with that. You tell this guy that if he has a legit opportunity to expose fraud and corruption and he doesn't do it, he is a piece of S in my book. That's what I say to him. He says, we'll delete the post and replace it with a post that says this is his suggestion. We'll delete our post and then replace it with a post that says we are currently in negotiations to secure the information and we are moving forward. It's best to show this cooperation. I promise we can move forward. And I say, you do it first and then I will do it. I will not make a new post. I will edit the current one. If you don't make a new post, he says, people will not see the news. It is a reasonable request, Brian. Let's work together. We can do this, please. And I said, I will edit the current post and make a new one with the same information. I am not deleting my post. He said, okay. He says, okay. And I said, tell me when you are done. And he says, he's done. I said, okay, I'm done. So I kind of made an edit or whatever. I said, I don't even remember what I wrote. So then I get a message, and we're almost done, guys. We're almost to the end of this whole thing. How long have we gone so far? I don't even know. So then I get a message from somebody saying, hey, can you vouch for Mormon documents? I've been, you know, I was PMing me and he asked me to send him money. And we agreed that I'd send him $700 for the audio instead of 7,500. Okay. Now this whole time he's supposedly telling me that we're going to work together to try to get this for free. And here I get some other Redditor sending me a screenshot of their conversation about how he just reached a deal to send him $700. And Mormon Documents is telling him to send it to him in Bitcoin. So I wrote to him, I said, why are you trying to make deals behind my back? And he goes, this is, and he says, this isn't me. Let me try to make this happen. I'm dealing with a lot of stress right now. And I said, dude, I've seen the screenshots of your PM with somebody. Half up front for 10 minutes of audio. I guess that was the original agreement. And he says, and then he says back to me, well, you've been the middleman before too. And then I said, well, do what you got to do. I told him not to give you a penny. Does your guy not realize that we will raise way more than $7,500 after the leaks, after the actual leak? And then he says he needs to use the money to leave the country he's in, and he can't use any of his church-controlled bank accounts to do it. Don't hinder this operation. And then I had been talking to this guy, a separate conversation with this guy that he was negotiating with, and I said, listen, I said, I don't think you should do this, but if you're dead set on doing it, let me send him, I'll send him the money and, you know, I'll take care of everything. And this guy said to me, he goes, you know, because I guess he'd gotten him down to like $750 was the agreement or whatever. And I said, look, I said, don't do it. I said, but if you're going to do it, I'd appreciate to, you know, be involved so I can see what's going on. And he said back to me, he goes, you know, $750 is nothing to me. I said, you know, for the chance to see if this guy is full of it or not, it's worth it. I said, okay, fine. So I messaged Mormon Documents. I said, hey, this guy you've been negotiating with, he's going to message you and he's going to tell you to work with me. And then we'll get you the $750 or 750 euros. So this guy sent me in PayPal $825, okay, which was what the exchange rate that day was. So I said, okay, I think I'm ready. This is what I say to him. Let's get on the same page. I have $870 worth of Bitcoin right now ready to send. How will you be sending me the files and approximately when? And he says, he is going to send the sample audio doc to me as soon as he gets the money. He will then immediately leave his location, go to a safe location, and then begin the data transmission of what he has. And I say, okay, will you be able to send me the audio file to my Proton mail? And he says, yes, I believe I can send it just like any other file. And I said, okay, give me a minute. And then I said, same Bitcoin address as before. This is important. And he says, send it to, and he gives me a Bitcoin wallet that's different from the one I was using previously. So I said, money sent. And I said, is that his Bitcoin? And I said, ask him to send as much audio as possible. I have several people who have pledged thousands of dollars for a legit leak. I give him my email address. And oh, and he says, that is my Bitcoin. Very important here. That is my Bitcoin. Give me another hour to work with him. Okay. And then I said, who is this other Bitcoin account? He says, that is also mine. Each account can generate multiple Bitcoin addresses, is what he's telling me. So he's telling me that was his Bitcoin wallet. And I said, okay, keep me posted. And he says, Ryan, please make a post that explains that I am not the leaker for this extremely sensitive information. People compared me to Mark Hoffman. Not cool. I just saw this. For the love of God, please reduce the chatter. I don't like being treated like this. And then I said, once I hear some audio, I will make a very nice but vague post calming everyone down. And I said, you think it's okay for people to compare me to a murderer? And I said, is that what I said? And he goes, no, by the way, I have not received the Bitcoin. And I said, okay, I'll be home in a couple minutes and I'll check it out. Thanks. And then I said, the app on my phone says it's sent. And I copied and pasted the Bitcoin address to him. And I said, is that the right address? And he goes, well, that's what it says on my end. Try sending it to another one, to the other one that we used before. And I said, I don't know if I can cancel. Can I even do that? It says transaction confirmed when I log onto my computer. I see no way to retract the transaction. He says, I just checked again and I still don't see it. And I said, well, what do we do? I can email support, I suppose. And I said, I just emailed support. Okay. And then I said, there appears to be no way of canceling. You may need to contact them on your end to ask why you can't see it, because he told me this is his Bitcoin account. And so then he says, I have no idea how to do that. And I copied and pasted the Bitcoin address again. And I said, are you 100% sure this is the address? And he says, yes. And he kind of says it in a weird way. And then I said, And then he goes, and then he sends me another Bitcoin address, says, send the money to this one. I said, dude, this is what I said to him. Dude, I don't have the money anymore. The transaction went through. And he goes, well, what are you going to do? And I said, are you accessing the account with the number? And it says zero. This is what I'm asking him. Or you can't even access the account. He says, I can access the account, but it says zero. And I said, is there anything that says pending transaction? And he says negative. And I said, okay, but the number, it matches, right? You didn't send me the wrong number. And he says, he sends me back saying, yes, the number matched. And I said, okay, I emailed support and asked them why you can't see it. I said, let's see what they respond. He goes, this is making me nervous. And he goes, I see no other option at this point than to wait and see what support says. And he says, let me know as soon as possible. In the meantime, and this is what I said to him. I said, in the meantime, I will, what is this? I don't even know what this is referring to. Anyway, I reiterate to him that if this all comes through, we'd be able to raise more than $7,500 for him. So now I tell him that, you know, he's going to need to contact support because support is not giving me any information other than that the transaction went through. And I said, go log on and send support. Okay. And then he emails me, says he wants the money to leave Germany and get to the safe house. That is what he's saying. Anything more would be using the system. That's what he said. And I said, I don't understand what he means by using the system. Anyway, there's nothing we can do about the money right now, but wait. And then he says, I see no option for support. Blah, 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 blah. So support finally contacted me and they explain to me how I could go into this website and I could see the tracking of this Bitcoin that I sent. And I'm able to go in and see that not only was the Bitcoin received, but like 5 minutes after it was received, maybe even less than that, it was immediately transferred out to another Bitcoin address. So I send him the proof of that. And I said, look, I said, your Bitcoin account received the money and then it was immediately sent to another account. Look at it here. I said, so you tell me, is that your account? Because I have triple checked the number and it is the number you have sent me multiple times. Let's see. He says, I don't understand what you mean by sent all over the place. I said, click on the tree because you click on this tree and you can see where the money went. Okay. I said, follow the orange circles. Tell your guy to contact me. And you can move out of the way. This is getting messy. And he's trying to say he doesn't understand this link I sent to him, whatever. And I said, look at the top right. There is your Bitcoin. Then the green arrow is who it was sent to. One is the transaction fee and the other is the wallet it was sent to. And he says, who received it? And I said, the number on the right, the second one. The first one is the transaction fee. He says, do we know how it happened? I said, no. Did you log on through Coinbase? And we go on this whole thing, right? So then I get a message from somebody while all this is happening. I get a message out of the blue from somebody that says, hey, I will give you $7,500 right now if you get this audio. I said, so I emailed, I sent them a screenshot of this guy's message. I said, hey, this guy's ready to hand over $7,500 right now. And I screenshotted, the guy sent me a screenshot of his bank account. He had like 600, I don't remember how much, like $600,000 in his bank account. So I screenshotted that to him. I said, tell your guy we're serious. We'll get him the money. Okay. This guy will give him. And then he goes on and on. He says, still haven't heard anything from my source, he's telling me. So then he says, I've heard nothing from Coinbase, you know, about this, you know, the from their customer service. He says, the source indicated he would be willing to speak once he received 750 euros. I sent him everything you sent me because he doesn't have the 750. I've been lambasted and ridiculed. I wish I could pinpoint where I went wrong. Personally, I am not doing well. And I said, what a cluster F you guys have created. All because your guy is chicken S and won't do the right thing. Tell him I said that. This is me to Mormon Documents. I sure hope that you figure out what happened to that Bitcoin, because that guy that sent it is not going to believe at all your story of this lost money, true or not, especially because it was magically sent immediately to a German account, which is where your guy supposedly is. Yeah, so this tree, this money tree thing that tracks the Bitcoin showed that it went into this account that I sent it to, and it was immediately transferred into a Bitcoin account that was based in Germany. And then I send him again. This guy that sent the money wants an update. I'm not going to be able to stall much longer. Tell this guy to send the audio. Seriously, I cannot wrap my mind around how stupid this whole thing has been. You write a dramatic post about how we, in quotation marks, have infiltrated the inner sanctum, all BS, money grab by some chicken-ass liar who is willing to hide evidence of a corrupt organization in order to save his own ass. And then he writes back to me, why are you calling me names? I'm trying to negotiate with him, Ryan. I have given him your contact information. I can't make him call you. And I said, what is there to negotiate? We have someone ready to give money, which is what he wanted. FYI, the guy that sent 850 now wants to call you out, because I told him about what happened. I sent him the proof that I sent the money and all this stuff. And he wanted to put a Reddit post about it all. And he asked me, he said, should I do it? And I said, FYI, the guy that sent the 850 now wants to call you out. Not sure if he's going to. And I said, and then I said, you should not be complaining about how I am talking to you. You brought this on yourself with that stupid post about infiltrating the mainframe. You brought me into this post without you brought me into that post without telling me first. Now I send you money and it mysteriously doesn't make it to you, but gets transferred to Germany right after I send it. And on top of that, we have money pledged to, and this guy wants to keep negotiating. Do you seriously not see how you went about this all the wrong way? And don't blame this on the other guy. This is both of you. He should hand over that info to a trusted person who can verify it, and money will flow. All this hype does nothing but hurt the ex-Mormon cause, and you seem to be completely oblivious to that. And then he doesn't respond for a while. So I said, no word. I said, I think this guy is going to hold off on outing you about the money, the guy that wanted to out him, but I'm not sure for how long. And then he makes the post outing him. And I said, now that this guy made a post, does that mean we're done? Because he was saying that if he outs him, we're done. Okay. All right. Crazy yet? Yes, it is freaking crazy. Okay. Let me see here. We're almost done, but let me get to those last couple of things. So, I mean, at this point, I don't even believe this guy, Mormon Documents, at all. Okay. At all. So then he says, out of the blue, he says, I need your help, please. Can you please help me eat and pay rent? I said, no, seriously, how is that supposed to happen? The last situation was a fiasco. Don't you realize that I have people who pledged thousands to your cause if you actually produced? Why won't you turn over your docs? I'm referring to the thousands of docs. I said, give me those docs and I will give you money, and I will get you money. And here is where the final shoe drops. He responds and says, I don't have any more docs. I'm sorry, I just want to survive. If I don't pay rent, I am going to get evicted. I haven't had anything to eat in 2 days. And then I respond, and I said, I thought you had thousands. You were supposed to send them to me, and I was supposed to give them to the New York Times. Do you not remember that? And then he says, I applied for food stamps today. My life is ruined. And I said, what am I supposed to do? Seriously, what do you propose I do? RX Mormon hates you. They want your head. And I said, I don't know. Maybe it's ruined. Maybe it's not, referring to his life. I know nothing about you. I see no way of helping you. And he says, I have scoured my computer and I can't find anything else. Remember, he told me multiple times that he had thousands of documents. He says, all I'm asking is for help, is just help for this month. Please, I am begging you. And I said, what would I do? I have no money to give you. Do you not recall threatening not to release these docs if we went public about the recent Bitcoin shenanigans? So you never had these docs, and then you clearly told me you did. Go back to Skype. You were very clear there that there were more damning documents. Tell me how this is not a scam. He says, I am going through my computer again and going through my cloud storage again to find remaining documents. I am asking for your help because I have nowhere else to turn. I just want to eat and survive. Please, Ryan. And I said, I have nothing to give. My car was stolen last week. Some of you may remember when my car was stolen. This was happening all when that happened. I said, I can't even afford to buy a new one. And he says, that sucks. And I said, can you drive for Uber? I'm trying to think of him getting a job. And he says, that would jeopardize my ability to receive health insurance and benefits due to my recent medical issues. And then I said, I waited like a day or two, and then I sent him this. I said, as I reflect on the months of interaction that you and I have had, it really does nothing more than piss me off. I sometimes lay in bed at night, trying to fall asleep, wondering what parts of you are real and what are fake. And it really bothers me. At this point, I'm pretty convinced that you had no friend that went to Germany. I'm also convinced that nobody had any audio. After your confession yesterday that you don't have the thousands of documents that you previously told me you did, I am convinced that you are nothing more than an opportunist, a charlatan. You probably are a former employee, ex-Mormon, who saw an opportunity to get some money out of people and string people along. Maybe you get some joy out of it. I don't know. Have you had health issues? Are you down on your luck financially? Who the hell knows? What I do know is that you have lied to me and to others, and you have caused me a great deal of stress. I hope you can understand and appreciate the pain that you have caused. I wonder if you can put yourself in my shoes and realize how ridiculous this looks when someone like you comes asking me for money after everything that's happened. I would love to be proven wrong, but I really doubt I will be. I suppose if I look on the bright side of this whole experience has been a great learning experience for me, and I will be better at what I do because of it. But I also wonder if it has hurt good people out there with good intentions. I don't know what I wrote here. I kind of wrote some bad grammar, so I'm trying to see what I tried to write. But I also wonder if it has hurt good people out there with good intentions who may come to me and I see them. Oh, I see. I'm saying, I wonder if it's going to hurt other good people who come to me with good intentions, and now I'm more skeptical than I should be because of my experience with Mormon documents. They say, anyway, I hope you are okay, and I hope you figure out what you need or want in life. If you're ever in a position to prove me wrong, feel free to contact me. And then he says, I gave tons of documents that would have otherwise gone unseen, and I compelled other individuals to release top secret videos. I disagree with your analysis. I am asking for help to survive. I will go through my cloud storage again, like I said yesterday, but I do not have the ability to pull anything out of my hat. I am just asking for a bit of help. Now, keep in notice here, he does not address the fact that I'm calling him out for lying to me about the 1,000 documents. He keeps dancing around that issue. And I write back, there is nothing to disagree about because I have the entire conversation to look back at. I don't believe you for one second that your friend went to Germany to get those docs on X. And if you recall, you said he did get them. You said he came back with the docs, but that your flu caused you not to caused him not to give them to you at the time. Well, where are those docs now? And don't give me BS that he is now afraid to release them because he took a massive risk in getting them, if that ever even happened. Sorry, all the positive you've contributed has been completely overridden by the lies and deceit. The latest Bitcoin, don't tell me you didn't get that. I don't believe you. It was immediately sent to somebody in Germany. There are no coincidences like that in life. Also, you told me the guy that sent you the money. Oh, because I found out he told that guy in a private message that he got scammed. I said, how does that work? The guy in Germany was supposedly somebody you knew personally. None of this adds up. And then he writes back, can you please help me? I'm starving. I need to pay rent. Please, Ryan, I'm begging you. And I said, I have nothing. Even if I wanted to, and I don't, I have nothing to send you. And I will not solicit anymore without solid information. And I get to decide what is solid. He says, I have a few more leaks. Can you please help me get some food and perhaps help with rent? And I said, your leaks have nothing to do with me. Oh, he says, I have made a few more leaks. So he posted a couple of other documents that were really nothing. I said, and he posted them on his own. I said, your leaks have nothing to do with me. You appear to be on your own. Good luck to you. And he says to me, you have a huge folder of stuff, Ryan. While you bask in the media spotlight, I am extremely ill and nearly homeless. I don't know what he meant by a huge folder of stuff. I think he meant like maybe the leaks I was getting on the website or whatever. I said, you brought this on yourself by lying to me. If you are so interested in working with me, why are you leaking by yourself on Reddit? And then he says, I didn't lie to you. Someone lied to me. I have no interest in creating more stress for myself. And the stuff that I've leaked, you had first. You just haven't leaked it yet. Oh, he's saying that I had that couple hundred documents that he sent me, you know, and that I could be leaking those things. And he says, all I'm asking is if you can help me one last time, please. I'm desperate for help. And I wrote back to him, do I need to screenshot the Skype where you said you had more documents and you will send them to me on a thumb drive so that we can work with the New York Times? And of course, that whole X fiasco, you know, the stuff from Germany. And he says, I sent you everything I had on the master folder. So now he's claiming that that initial zip drive with a couple hundred documents was everything he had. All I'm asking is a chance to have a Christmas dinner. I think I deserve that after the year I've had, filled with death threats and fear. And I said, there is nothing I can do to help you. I have no money, and I am not sticking my neck out for you again. And you did lie to me. I will screenshot the conversation where you told me that was not everything. Also, you said you never received the Bitcoin, and I know you did. You lied, pure and simple. And I don't even know who you are. Geez, messed up on so many levels. And he says, so you're not going to help me have Christmas dinner after everything I did for you? And I said, nope, I don't respond well to lies. And he says, I did not lie. Someone was feeding me false information. And then here, and he keeps talking about, you know, this false information. He's referring to the fact that he got screwed over with this like $850 in Bitcoin. So I say, okay, you keep going to that recent thing. You gave me a Bitcoin wallet that you specifically told me was yours. I asked why it was different, and you said it was another one of yours. Then you said you never got it. You lied. You said that you had the documents to give to the New York Times beyond what you gave me. You lied. You said you have some friend who stole documents from the church in Germany and only didn't give them to you because you looked sick. Well, now you're not sick. Where is this? Where is the documents? I'm guessing you lied. Stop trying to say you didn't lie to me because you did. The only thing I don't know for certain is how many lies you told me. You also seem to have no appreciation for what I did for you. I called in favors for you. I probably burned a bridge for you. I believed you. I just wanted to have somewhat normal Christmas by myself. I have no one. And I said, I'm sure you can find a place in New York City that can help you out. Or was that a lie too? Do you actually live there? And then he says, whatever, Ryan, I'm asking for a modicum of support one last time. You don't have to be sarcastic or rude. I worked very hard as much as I could. And then I said, I have nothing to give you. I have not even replaced my stolen car yet. My kids are having a downsized Christmas because of that. What do you want to hear from me? And by the way, this was a couple days before Christmas, and right around Christmas, my car was actually recovered. So all's well that ends well, but things were looking really grim for us there for a minute because I thought I was going to have to buy a car. If I still believed in prayer, I would pray for you, he says. This is in response to my stolen car and my kids' downsized Christmas. Sometimes I wish I never learned the truth, he says. I wish I could help you. And I said, I can't help you with money, but if you really want to do something good, why don't you stop posting on Reddit and let me leak whatever documents you would get out there? It will get more media attention that way. I said, I am starving, Ryan, literally. And I said, even though I can't help with you right now, you can still do the right thing with all those documents. I haven't had a chance to go through every single one. I'm referring to the couple hundred he sent me. As you find ones that are interesting, you can still let me know. And then he says, and so he goes, and just so you know, I am incredibly thankful and grateful to you. He's trying to maybe, I don't know, save a little bit of face here. He goes, you have helped me so much, both emotionally and financially. And then I just responded, okay. So there were a few more interactions with him as Mormon Leaks website got some success. And at one point, let me see here. There was one last thing. Oh, he says to me, this is one last interaction I want to do. So this was 2 months ago. This is the last significant interaction that I had with him. He says, hello. And I say, what's up? He says, did you get the recent message about donations from my GoFundMe page? And he says, I wrote, I don't know if you noticed or not, but there have been a few donations that make up a GoFundMe that made it to my GoFundMe account. As you know, I'm in dire circumstances right now, both medically and financially. If you could get those donations to me ASAP, that would be fantastic. Okay. And he's telling me he only has 12 cents or whatever. And then I didn't realize I was misunderstanding his message. I thought that he was implying that I had, that there were GoFundMe money that was still out there from what that people were sending to me and that I hadn't sent him. And I said, I'm not giving you any more money if that's what you're asking me. Cause I didn't know that somebody had just made a donation. I thought I had turned off the fundraiser, but apparently somebody had just made like, it was like a $50 donation or something. He goes, the money was donated to me. Are you telling me you're not going to give me money that was donated to me? And then I said, okay, well, I'll look into that tomorrow. I realized there was a miscommunication here and that he was saying that there was fresh money donated. So, I just messed it up. So then I said, okay, I'll have it to you in 2 to 5 business days. And he said, thank you very much. So I sent him that $50. Oh, here we go. I said, now, I didn't see your previous message, which was what caused the confusion. If it seems like I'm coming off harsh, it's because I don't appreciate people who lie to me, pure and simple. You took advantage of me, whether you want to admit it or not. That whole thing about your friend who flew to Germany to get documents was a crock full of S. Feel free to prove me wrong, and I will be the first one to apologize. Until then, expect no more than a cold shoulder from me. And then he says, I did not lie to you. My source lied to me. You can't hold me accountable for things I have no control over. Next time, I won't jump the gun. And I said, really? So you had a guy tell you that he was flying to Germany, that he was supposedly communicating with you while he was in Germany, told you he had the goods. Then you went to meet him, and he said he was going to take you to the hospital because of how bad you looked, and he would give you the documents later. Then you disappear off the face of the earth, only to reappear later to implicate me in a post I knew nothing about, and that was part of another shakedown of supposedly another person that scammed you. Or was that the same person? Are you telling me that the same person scammed you twice? BS, you know, whatever. Don't insult my intelligence. If this is true, which it isn't, give me that guy's name. Why are you protecting the guy that would scam you like that? I am not trying to insult your intelligence. I told you what happened. Out of everything I've done, I believe that I precipitated an onslaught of leaks. He wants credit for, you know, the success of Mormon Leaks. Obviously, that was my first and foremost interest. I'm interested in moving forward and working for transparency and exposing the church for what it is. I have been duped. But as the saying goes, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. I honestly think this guy has stuff, and I know for damn sure he has the audio because I heard it. So again, let's move forward and keep doing what we need to do to accomplish what we have set out to do. If you keep calling me a liar, then you are not going to convince me to do anything. We are past this. We need to move forward in unison. Please, this negativity is not conducive to accomplishing our mission. And I didn't respond there to him. And I think I sent him a message telling him that I sent him the Bitcoin, the $50. Oh, and then he says he wants to call me. So now he actually calls me. He called me, I think, twice. And he now tells me the name of this guy that supposedly scammed him. And I'm not even going to say this guy's name because I don't even believe it. But he claims to me that this guy is all top secret this, top secret that, and that, you know, he played Mormon documents like a fiddle and whatever. He claims this guy orchestrated the hacking of ordained women, which I don't believe. I mean, I actually believe that church hacked ordained women. I don't believe this guy was involved in it. So he's telling me this whole big story. He's finally coming clean, telling me names and all this stuff, right? And so I said, okay. I said, I'll tell you what. I've got the ability to get a hold of 60 Minutes in 2020. I said, let's go talk to him. You come forward, we'll get you some money, and you go on the record with this stuff. You say all this is true, let's go on the record. Oh, no, I can't do that. And then he asks me to help him financially again. And I said, dude, I'm not going to do it, you know, without exposing all this stuff. I said, look, if any of this stuff is true, man up, put your name on it, and let's go public with it. Otherwise, it's a lie in my book. And there's been a couple of random messages here and there, but for the most part, that's been it. So he goes and puts yesterday some post that he's leaking that Thomas Monson is dead and that he has it from his inside sources, two of them. I think he even said he had two sources confirm it, that he died yesterday, the 5th of April, at around 1 o'clock Mountain Time, I want to say. And then, of course, you know, a lot of people don't know the history of this guy, Mormon Docs, and he erased all of his old posts, so people can't put two and two together. Also, although some people did, and people are believing him, and some people are calling him out and whatever. He made a second post where he supposedly posted the email, which I am suspect as to whether or not that email is real. I don't know if it is or not. If it is a real email that he received from the church, then somebody's playing him like a fiddle. But most likely, since we know that Thomas Monson is not dead, most likely he made that email up. I'm thinking that he saw an opportunity, that it was a high likelihood that Monson died, and so he was hoping to capitalize on that, and then if he happened to be right, he would ask for money. That's my thought. But I saw this post that he was doing yesterday, and I said, I need to finally tell the story. So here it is. I told the story. I have no idea how long I've gone so far. I apologize. I hope I've kept it interesting. I know some of you probably cut out because it's not interesting enough. Some of you probably listened to this to the end. But there it is. And, you know, my final thoughts on it are I'm so conflicted as to whether or not he really is an ex-Mormon down on his luck. He might be. I mean, somehow he came into these documents. The documents that he released were legit, and they were documents that are not widely available. So whether or not he came into them because of his employment with the church or whatever, I mean, I just don't know. My suggestion going forward is to just not believe anything he says unless he actually releases something, and then that goes through, you know, whatever vetting, and there's some level of trust there. So there it is, preserved for time and all eternity, the official record of what happened behind the scenes between Ryan McKnight and Mormon Documents. It is true that my interaction with him, as horrible as it turned out, probably did play a huge role in Mormon leaks being successful. Would the person with the 15 videos had come to me anyway? Who knows? But I do think that it's fair to say that he had some influence on that, and I suppose deserves a little bit of credit. But that credit is accompanied with a huge, fat, massive piece of salt, massive grain of salt. So anyway, if you guys have questions, maybe put them in the comments of the video. I'll try to respond, or you can I'll make a Reddit post posting this, and I'll try to answer questions in the Reddit post. Other than that, peace out.